Let's start over.
It's the first word.
All right, check it out. Teams getting off a plane. Never understood why guys shoot video. When are you going to go back to you getting off a plane? It was such a magical moment. Look at Hines Ward there. It's a feeling the Steelers already know. 25 have played in this Super Bowl before. A combined 54 rings. Packers only have two players who have played in the game before. Their one ring, John Kuhn, who got it as a practice player for the Steelers 5 years ago. How much of a factor does experience play in the Super Bowl, Bomani?
There's nothing that momentous that you're ever better off for having never done before. So you have to say it's a factor on the side of the Steelers, just because not only have they been there, the last time they went, that game against the Cardinals has as many ups and downs as you could possibly imagine. So I can't see anything that could happen against the Packers, as tight as that point spread is, as tight as that game could be. What could it be that they haven't seen before? But at the same time, Eugene Robinson went to 3 Super Bowls in a row, and it was the third one where he didn't realize all the rules. It means but so
Flag
much.
Of stone.
Well, I think it means a big deal. I mean, you just look at this being the third time in the last 6 years that the Steelers have gotten this far. They've almost become a fixture in the Super Bowl. And they've got a guy and a quarterback who's been there, who got better in his second Super Bowl out. You've got a guy like Hines Ward, who was telling me in the locker room the other week how special it was for him to go to a third Super Bowl.
Inside
and how much appreciation he had for it. Never thought he'd get to 3 in his career. Heath Miller getting back to the Super Bowl. Obviously, Mike Tomlin, a veteran now of the Super Bowl, and there's nobody really on the Packers that can say that. You know, they're getting to a place where everybody wants to get to, and they're finally getting there. A guy like Aaron Rodgers. So I think that experience means a great deal when you get to the Super Bowl.
Experience is so critical, I think, in a Super Bowl game. If you look back the history of the game, you'll see that there have been 8 repeat champions. So you can see that once you've been there, you understand it. And I remember what John Madden said. Before the year starts, everybody says, our goal this year is to get to the Super Bowl. Nobody says we want to win the Super Bowl unless you've been there in the last 2 or 3 years. And I don't think people understand the distractions. And we're not talking about team photos. We're talking about getting tickets for your family, places to stay. And the guys that haven't been there before don't really understand that there's so many aspects they have never faced, so many members of the media. They don't know exactly what it's like on game day when you come out on that field. So I think having been there before, you really understand and you accept it in a different way than if you hadn't been there.
Well, I don't have the inside scoop to getting to a Super Bowl is special like Kevin Blackstone delivered.
But I'm glad somebody pointed that out.
At the Super Bowl 40 in Detroit, looking through my binoculars at Ben Roethlisberger before the game, and he just seemed out of sorts. He seemed like he was trying too hard to look casual when he wasn't. He was nervous, admittedly so afterward, and he played that way. A QB rating of 22.6 through 2 interceptions. His second time at the Super Bowl, what happened? 21 for 30, led that great drive at the end, threw that touchdown pass to win the game. So the thing is, you don't know how Aaron Rodgers or other critics Packers are going to respond.
I hear what everybody's saying and how important experience is, but let's go back to last year. The Saints versus the Colts. Breeze had never been there before. Manning had Blackstone. What happened? Breeze won the game.
Well, I mean, that's just one time. I mean, you're not talking about a Steelers team, and the Colts hadn't been there in the span of time that the Steelers had been there. So, I mean, I think these kind of things happen. You can look back at the Giants and the Patriots, the same kind of thing. That happens. That still doesn't mean experience doesn't make a difference. And, oh, by the way, everybody talks about the distractions that you get into in the Super Bowl. What team has had more distractions going into this season than the Steelers with Roethlisberger?
Maybe the Jets. Jones.
Eli Manning beat Tom Brady, so it matters. It's just not a be-all, end-all trump card.
Paige.
Well, and if you notice in both those games we've been talking about, they came down to one play at the end. So, again, I think experience really does help you. But
we know
the turnovers.
Now we have two examples in the recent history of this Super Bowl. We've got the Saints last year. We have the Giants with David Tyree making a catch off his helmet. Tyree had no experience in the Super Bowl. He makes the catch, and the Giants win the game on the Burris touchdown a little while later.
And the Giants had almost beaten the Patriots right at the end of the year, too, win a fabulous game.
Yeah, they had experience against going against them.
So what do we say? Here. I don't think we're saying anything. We're moving on. Basketball now. Lakers GM Mitch Kupchak told the LA Times he's unhappy with his team's complacency of late, and he's thinking about making a trade. A Lakers trade. I think that's all you guys need to know. Does the trade make sense? And if so, who should they be targeting, Adande?
Well, they sure need to shake things up. I mean, they haven't gotten it done in any of these marquee games. But if you think about it, they don't have what teams are looking for, and that's expiring contracts. You're not going to trade Kobe Bryant or Lamar Odom or Pau Gasol. And the reason they were able to get Gasol in the first place for Kwame Brown, Kwame had an expiring contract. So without that type of deal, I mean, Ron Artest is long-term. Luke Walton's long-term. All these guys have long-term contracts. So you're not going to see a Trinkets for Manhattan type of deal like they got with Pau Gasol. So, I mean, there's a small forward, which is what they need. I know there's one available in Denver, Woody, but the Lakers don't have Woody the assets to make that happen.
2 years ago, they went out and got Gasol. That made a difference in winning the championship. Last year, they added Ron Artest. They've got to do that again. They need one more player. Their bench isn't deep enough. And specifically, who do I target? I go to the Cleveland Cavaliers. I get Antoine Jameson. I think he's a player that Cleveland wants to get rid of, high salaried, and you in return could go get a Joe Smith from the Lakers, a Theo Radcliffe. What do they have? Nothing to help you this year but expiring contracts. And you said Luke Walton, his contract expires next year. So
you say Jameson.
Kind of
this is interesting to me because yesterday we said
don't match up.
Defense was a real problem for the Lakers. Is Jameson bringing much on that play there, Paige?
Well, I think experience, some need up front where they have injuries and they have issues. I think that he could come in. His career would be revived there. He's the kind of guy they need.
Oh, the problem isn't that they need to make a trade. The problem is they need to get better production out of the players they have. I mean, we saw Pau Gasol go back to his old soft self over the weekend. They can't have that. They need to get more out of Ron Artest. He's not playing at the level that he was playing at a year ago. That's what they need to do. And they do need to tighten the screws a little bit on defense. But let's not forget, this is still a team that's got 33 wins. They're going through a rough patch right now. That happens during the NBA season. A lot of teams are going to hit a rough patch. They're just going to have to work their way
Jones.
Out of it.
Well, the problem is Jerry West was right. This team is a bit long in the tooth, and so you could say they need depth, absolutely, but they don't have anybody on the bench that can get them back anything better than what they have. You go through the tradable assets that they've had, Lamar Odom, Pau Gasol, Kobe Bryant, nobody's going to take those guys. Andrew Bynum, they're not going to give those guys up. So if you don't have anything that you can get back for the things that you're willing to give up, all you can hope is that Pau Gasol trades in whatever is going on now for his better game, because the Lakers are good when Pau Gasol plays aggressively.
Why do you
He's their
think
most important
Kupchak
factor.
Put this out there, Adonde?
Well, clearly to send a signal to his guys that this is unacceptable. You hear a lot of talk that it's the regular season, we'll be fine when the playoffs come around. And Kupchak understands that if they go in with that laissez-faire attitude, it's not going to get it done. Because just a week or two ago, I was told by a member of the organization they weren't looking to make
Paige.
A trade. Clearly that Boston loss changed things in Lakerland.
I think for two reasons. Number one, the motivated zone players. And number two, they haven't been in the talks about trades. And now he's put the word out there. We're interested.
Blackstone.
Two reasons.
Exact same thing Magic Johnson did when he had a piece of that team a few years ago. Said the exact same kind of thing to get that team going in the right direction.
But I only heard one player's name for a possible trade here. Jameson out there. And that's what Paige threw. No
one
else.
Work.
No. And that doesn't even work with the financial. It doesn't really work on the defensive front. The eminence front.
$91 million payroll now.
We're taking a break.
Put on.
Coming up, buy or sell. Thank you, Adonde. I thought somebody would be there with me.